everybody. I hope you enjoyed your wonderful Thanksgiving weekend. Now we are in December, and we're going to learn about a famous artist who we actually see a lot this time of year. And even better, he was born right here in Massachusetts. All right, so let's learn about this amazing artist. This is Theodore Geisel. You know him better today as Dr. Seuss. Dr. Seuss was born on March 2, 1904, right near here in Springfield, Massachusetts. Today they have a museum dedicated to him there. In his lifetime, he created over 60 books and sold over 600 million copies of them. This is the time of year when we see his work the most. His famous children book, The Grinch, has been made into many different versions of cartoons and movies. Today we're going to look at his very special artistic style, which sets him apart from all the rest. As you know, there are two different types of shapes. One is geometric, which has straight and perfect sides, while organic is flowy and bumpy. Looking at this example from The Grinch, would you say that his architecture style is using geometric or organic shapes? If you said organic shapes, you are correct. Look at how bumpy and flowy those houses are. They're curved and swirls and all different organic shapes used in them. So now that we know all about Dr. Seuss, we're going to be creating a landscape in the style of his artwork. As you can see, I have lots of houses. I've got a crooked snowman, and they're using organic shapes instead of geometric. All right, let's go get creating. Okay, so we're going to be drawing some Dr. Seuss-inspired landscapes. So I've got my drawing paper. I've got coloring supplies. You get to choose how you want to color it today. I'm also giving you a cheat sheet on different styles of houses that you could draw. Okay, do you have to do them exactly like this? Absolutely not. You can create your own, but this will be uploaded into the Google Classroom to help you. Okay. So since we're going to be drawing, I want you at home to use pencils because of that wonderful eraser on the back in case you make a mistake. I, however, am going to be using Sharpie because it'll be easier to see through the camera, okay? So first thing we need in a landscape is a horizon line that separates the sky from the bottom. So right across, I can do a straight line if I want, or maybe since I want a bumpy one to show that it's hilly. Okay, so that is a horizon line. Okay, so my first house. Do I want to make geometric square triangle houses? No, because that's not what Dr. Seuss did. So they could be bumpy, they could be crooked, they could be on an angle. So drawing a line, I'm going to do my first house. Let's make it bumpy and a little crooked. Let's combine the two. So I've got a weird organic shape here, and then let's add a weird door to it, okay, and how about our roof? So how about I make one, I kind of like that elf looking style house. I can add some details like stripes, okay, the more details we add kind of makes it our own. And even around the door, I can make some weird organic lines. There, now it's looking more Seuss-like. And how about a little crooked chimney? Yeah. All right, first house down. Okay, the second one I'm going to put over here. All right, maybe I want this one to be straight on one side. And then a little wavy and crooked on the other. But a straight door. And then I like curly cues. I'm going to make some organic curly cues. All right. And this one will add a window in. That looks pretty neat. And then if we're going with curly cues, curly cue house. Let's put another window up top. Mm-hmm. All right, what about in the middle? Maybe I want to make a snowman, but it would be a very different snowman. Might be a little crooked. Oh, and since it's Dr. Seuss, let's make it a really tall cat in the hat type of snowman. Even make it the cat in the hat. Love it. Give him a scarf. All right, so you can add all different details. Okay, there's windows. Presents. You could stack presents over here. You could put a Christmas tree in the window. All right. The other thing I'm going to be giving you is a sheet with characters so I can use my eyes, and maybe I want to draw what the Grinch looks like. So maybe he's over here. Or if you want, you can actually cut out the characters and glue them into your scene if you have a printer at home. If not, you can draw them. Okay? Don't forget the snow at the bottom. Maybe you want to do, I don't know, some doorsteps or a banner that says, Merry Christmas. You could even draw, not crumpet in the background. Okay, so there's a lot that you can do. Okay, so I want to see some organic shape houses, just like Dr. Seuss. You can make your landscape picture however you want. Okay, don't forget some presents because it is Christmas time in Seussville. All right, once you got it drawn, feel free to color it however you want. Okay, I'm going to color mine right now.
Trim up the tree with Christmas stuff like bingo balls and hoop hoop fluff. Trim up the tree with goo goo gums and bizzle bits and ones.
Trim every blessed window and trim every blessed door.
Hang up hoo boo hoo bricks.
Then run out and get some more.
Hang Ventucas on the ceiling, pile Pampunas on the floor. Trim every blessed needle on the blessed Christmas tree. Christmas comes tomorrow. Trim you, trim me. Trim up the tree with Fuzzle Fuzz and Blipper Bloops and Wuzzle Wuzz. Trim up your uncle and your aunt with yards of hoof-on-flame.
All right, so here is my Dr. Seuss style landscape. Okay, I went and decorated my houses. I've got some string of lights, I've got presents. I even went and cut it out and glued it onto a background paper, kind of like a frame around it. All right, so I can't wait to see your organic shaped houses and how creative you can get with this in honor of Dr. Seuss. All right, so have fun, upload them into the Google Classroom, and I'll see you next time. Bye, guys.